Hello friends, welcome back to my channel Topper's World. In this video, I'm going to solve reading section 3rd of journal IELTS, book number 12, test number 5. And this is the third section, which is usually considered a very hard section. So I'm trying to solve this section for you. So keep watching till the end. So topic of this passage is a brief history of automata. Automata is something related to automation or automatic things. We know that in these days so many things are automatic, like machines or devices. So how these automatic things generated, what is their history, and what kind of things were there in the past that were fully automatic or partially automatic. This is all about automatic things of the past time. So first of all, let's see the questions. First set of questions 28 to 30 are based upon blanks, one word only. This is a sort of summary type. 31 to 35 questions are based upon descriptions of some items or some things, and the list of people who described these things or who said something about these things. And you can see the list of people is a very large list from A to G. And the questions are only 5, so I think almost 2 extra people are given over here to create confusion in the mind of the student. So we will sort out, we will solve this. And the last 36 to 40 are again blanks. 5 blanks are given and you have to write one word only. So let's start from the first set of questions. The technique that I am going to use here to find out the answer is searching for the keywords in the passage and then focusing little bit around that keyword to find the answer. So first question is, the ancient Greeks had a number of dash concerning automata. A number of dash. So a number of means here there are some things which are in more in number, right? Like they are in plural. Bahuvachan mein hai, they jada hai. So here had a number of, यहाँ पे जो noun आएगा that will be in the plural, the noun will be plural here. So let's find out the Greek ancient Greeks. This is our keyword, the ancient Greek. So where we find this word, we will have the answer nearby. So I am having this ancient Greek word here in the third line, the ancient Greeks. So I have to read a few words before. Several myths show that the ancient Greeks were interested in the creation of automata. So in this line we have plural s. The word is with myths. This is the plural noun. So we will try to find out that whether this word fits there in the blank. The ancient Greeks had a number of myths concerning automata. So myths means something which you cannot logically think of. So this can be lies or baseless ideas. So usko kehte hain myth, jo jhoot hota hai. So this the word is, answer is here, myths. M-Y-T-H-S. According to one, the god Hephaestus created 2 assistants made of gold. Created 2 assistants made of gold. This person created, this person is a god, Greek god. He created 2 persons made of gold. The Greeks probably also created real automata. It seems most likely that mechanism which controlled them consisted of dash, which were worked by human operators. So these automatic things controlled, which controlled them consisted of dash, the controlling system. So we have to find out the, what system was there which controlled these automatic devices, which were worked by human operators. So humans used to operate them and there are certain control systems. So we have to find out that what control systems are there. And the key word is human operators. This will help us to find mechanism human operators. So here the third line from the end of the paragraph, these were probably activated by levers and powered by human action. Human action will represent human being, and they use their power to control the machine with the help of certain levers. So lever is the most suitable word over there in the second blank. Now you can see that it seems most likely that mechanism which controlled them consisted of levers which were worked by human operators. Now the third blank is, some automata were designed to be dashed with an educational purpose. So key word is educational purpose. So it's not necessary that we will find educational purpose as it is written in the paragraph. There may be some parallel wording for this. So automata were sometimes intended as toys or as tools for demonstrating basic scientific principles. So basic scientific principles means education, and they are used as tools for demonstrating basic scientific principles. So tool is the right word that we have to fill in the blank. So let's try to make sense of this once again. Some automata were designed to be tools with an educational purposes. So here answer is tools. So in this way we did three blanks. Now we are moving for next section of the questions. So here we have been given a list of people. The best method to do such kind of question is to, we should start reading the passage, and whatever the person we see, we should focus on that person and his creation or whatever he said. And after that, we should try to relate that person with the given question sentences. So in the list of people, we have first Stebius. This is a very difficult name, so I'm going to just pronounce it C. So here this person is mentioned. In Egypt, Stebius experiment with air pressure and pneumatic principles. One of his creation was singing blackbird powered by water. So he made a bird which powered by water, and he also made some things which worked on air pressure. So these are the two keywords here, and now we should find out whether these two keywords are there in any statement. So here you can clearly see the 35th statement, used air and water power. Used air and water power. So which person used air and water power to make machines, automatic machines? That is Stebius. So our answer of 31st question is A. Now next persons are herb engineers. Now we will find this keyword in the passage and try to assess what they said or what they did about automation. The good thing about this kind of question is that the persons are always given in same order. As you move to one person to other person, you will get their description. Much later, herb engineers of the 9th and 13th centuries wrote detailed treatises on how to build programmable musical fountains, mechanical servants, and elaborate clocks. So they wrote something. They wrote detailed documents or treatises. Now look at question number 33. Produce documents about how to create automata. So that relates to the herb engineers. So I'm going to put B here. The B is right answer. Next person is Da Vinci. So here is the mentioning of Leonardo da Vinci, who made a lion in honor of King of France, which advanced towards him, stopped, opened its chest. So in these lines, the creation of Da Vinci, that was a lion, and it tells us that how the lion used to do the various activities like stopping, opening his mouth or jaw, claws, etc. So let's find out statements in the question. So I have already read these statements, and there is no mentioning of any lion and its working principle. So there is no answer that is related to C. Now we should move to the next, that is Mailardert. Number D, Mailardert. So here on the next page there is a mentioning of this person, Mailardert, made extensive use of gearing and cogs to produce automata of horses. He created horses, automatic horses, worked by turning a handle. So how these horses move on or worked upon, there were certain handles. So handles are operated by the human beings by their hands. Handle word itself shows that there is something like that which can be operated by hand. So let's read the statement. So look at the statement 34, created automata which required a human being to operate the mechanism. So horses' handles could only be operated by the human being at that time. So our 34 answer matches with D, because handle is something that human beings used to operate with. And next is Vaucanson. So let's find out where this person is mentioned. This is Vaucanson. So Vaucanson has been mentioned just after Mailardert. Vaucanson produced a duck made of gilded copper, which ate, drank, and quacked like a real duck. He also made a life-size female flute player. Air passes through the complex mechanism, causing lips and fingers of the player to move. So he created a musical instrument type thing. He made a life-size female flute player. Means he made a female statue which used to play flute. Flute means bouncery. Air passes through the complex mechanism. Now, next, these are the workings of that flute explained. The musical instrument, how it was played by the large size female. So this answer will match with 32 statements. This statement number 32, created an automation that performed a musical instrument. So answer E. 32 is E. So only 31st is left. Created an automation that represented a bird in water interacting with its surroundings. So after the Vaucanson, our next person is Merlin. So we will locate or search about this person in the passage. In another well-known piece, Merlin Silver Swan, made in 1773, the swan sits in a stream consisting of glass rods where small silver fish are swimming. So this is something that created by Merlin, which worked in water. When the clockwork is wound, a music box plays and glass rods rotate, giving an impression of consisting flowing stream. The swan turns its head from side to side. It soon notices the fish and bends down to catch and eat one. So means this is something automatic toy that works in water and also interact or react to the things around. For example, it eats fish. So we got our answer. The answer is 31. Created an automation that represented a bird in water interacting with its surrounding. So F is the right answer over here. Now we are going to move for our next set of questions. We have a set of blanks, and the technique like searching for the keywords or parallel wording in the passage will help us over here. The mechanical theater shows court life inside a dash. Mechanical theater shows court life. They are the main words. So there is information about mechanical theater in this paragraph. We just scan the information. Another stunning creation of 18th century mechanical theater ground, Austria, Heilbronn. Archbishop servers designed by completed in 1752. This depicts means shows the nobility's idea of a perfect society with every class in its proper place. The figures inside a palace depict 18th century court life. Court life word we got, and depict word we got. Depict means shows. Inside where? In the palace, in a palace. So our right answer is palace here. So look at the question. Mechanical theatre shows court life inside a palace. Next is, in mechanical theatre, building workers, butchers and barbers represent various dash of time. Various dash of the time. So keywords, workers, butchers and barbers, they are all the workers. And various dash of time, various businesses, various trades of time, aisa kuch ho sakta hai. That can be like this. Okay, now look at the area. The figures inside a palace depict 18th century court life, while the industrial activity is carried out on in around the building. A total 141 mobile and immobile figures demonstrate all manner of trades of the period, like building workers bring material, foreman who drinks, butchers, slaughter. So they are different trades. So this word is over there that we have to fill. I just said you that some businesses are trades. So the trade is the right word over there. So I just filled the trades here. Some answers you can just imagine, just predict. Dash provides the power that operates mechanical theater. Dash provide power. So there is something that provides power. That can be electricity, that can be wind, that can be water. So I am imagining the answer over here. Now I will try to find out which word would be there in the passage. Whether it will be water, it would be air, or it would be electricity. So electricity is not possible, but that was, we are talking about very old time when electricity was not invented. So there would be wind or water, something like that. Now, the theatre shows a great skill in clock making and water technology, consists of hidden water wheels, copper wiring and cog wheels. So the theatre shows great skill and it works on hidden water wheels. So what will propel the wheels? Water. So water energy is being used over there to work on all that mechanical theatre. So answer to question number 38 is water. New dash that developed in the 19th century reduced the cost of production of automata. New dash. So new dash that developed in. So it's clear that there can be, the most suitable word is technology, or can be skill, or any strategy, technique, technology, methodology. There will be something like that in the blank. So this technique is called making prejudgments or presumptions regarding the answer. So yahan pe most suitable word is technology, technique, method, methodology, way. During the 19th century, mass production techniques meant the automata could be made cheaply and easily. Mass production techniques. So answer there is new technique. So answer is new technique that developed in 19th century reduced the cost of production of automata. During the 19th century, most automata were intended for use by. So in 19th century, most automata were intended for use by humans, people, workers, laborer, elderly, younger, children. So there will be some noun which will be which will show human being. So let's find out. So I'm going to read from the same paragraph. Cheaply and easily they became toys for children rather than the expensive adult amusement. Between 1860 and 1910, small family businesses. So they are talking about 19th century and they became toys for children. So our right answer is there. During the 19th century, most automata were intended for use by children is the right word. So in this way we have completed our whole section third. I hope that you enjoyed learning this. Thank you very much for watching this video.